Okay, Michael, so here's a quiz.
Now,
it's a pretty straightforward quiz. I just want you to use everything that you've learned so far. Okay, so you have three hypotheses. Let's call them H1, H2, and H3,
mm-hmm.
okay, for the sake of argument.
Mm-hmm.
Here is what each of these hypotheses outputs for some particular x. H1 says plus, H2 says minus, H3 says minus, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Now here we've already made it easy for you and we've computed the probability of a particular hypothesis given some set of data. I'm not showing you the data, but I'm showing you the answer for it, okay? So the probability of H1 given the data is 0.4, H2 is 0.3, and H3 is 0.3. Got it?
Wait, hang on. So, okay, I see. That corresponding hypothesis given the data, what's x?
X is some input. It doesn't matter. Just like it doesn't matter what the data is.
Okay.
Just call it, so the x is x, okay? It's mm-hmm. just some object out in the world, and each hypothesis labels it plus or minus.
Okay.
Or can label it plus or minus. And H1 decides that for that x, it's positive, and the other two hypotheses decide that it is, in fact, negative. And H1 has a probability, that is the maximum a posteriori probability, is 0.4. For H2, it's 0.3, and for H3, it is 0.3. So my question to you is very simple, using all of the magic that we've done, but this is just to make certain that you've got it, Michael, because,
uh-oh.
I don't know. We've okay. done a lot of derivations. We've walked away from some things. I want to make sure we get back to basics here. What is the best label for x? Is it plus or is it minus?
I see why this is tricky. Okay.
And go.